The time has come to establish the United States Space Force.
Think of that. Space Force.
Space Force! Space Force! But there's no threat in space. Who are we fighting? Satellites?
This is worse than Pearl Harbor. This is worse than the World Trade Center. There's never been an attack like this.
Oh, my God.
Hong Kong, no more to stand with China. We need independence.
Anyway, fuck you, motherfucker.
Their eyes so slant, they can't see the fucking tree.
Let's say China.
The blood is on the hands of the Chinese Communist Party.
You go over to China.
I have to have my China.
You want
to
buy from China?
Fuck you,
that's
man.
Great. Buy from China. Buy toys from China.
China in particular. China.
China. I have people that I know in China. China. China.
Down with China. Down with China.
China.
My name is Andy.
You know, China.
I know China very well.
China.
We're having a little squabble with China. You know what? You want to know something? You want to know something? We always win. We always win.
What would I?
Just bigger.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Woo! Woo! For my first go around. It was good. Good try. I mean, it's way different than the phone.
Yeah, you get to fuck around and do intros while people fucking die because police are violent towards black people, and you're a piece of shit.
I don't know why you just did that to me, man. What? You know I had a hard week.
I watched
you
that.
You know I had a really hard week.
I watched that 1.5 times.
I don't know how you did that.
Hey, man.
I for real don't know where that's headed. That's only in the middle of the year. You're like hurting my chest with that.
Yeah. It's a
like
good show.
You know I'm on mushrooms and I'm fucking I have half of a coffee in me. I've had a hard week with no sleep.
Dude, no, I'm like 2020, come on. Death of 2020. Netflix came out with a bango, dude.
Hey man, I don't know why you had to do that to
that
me.
That was funny
I'm
as
trying
shit.
To like I'm trying to like get pumped to do this.
That was funny as shit.
Yeah, man, I don't feel pumped. I don't feel like that was funny. I don't feel pumped up, dude. I don't feel good. I watch that. I don't feel good. Dude, I'm always breaking your balls about how, like, you won't read.
Yeah,
like,
I know. That's what I was saying.
Dude, holy shit. Like, I feel for you, bro. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I watched it 1.5 times.
I don't know how
I'll finish it.
I don't know how you did that, dude.
The way I get through it,
of propaganda.
The way I get through it is I sit there and, like, when they do their punchlines and they do their jokes.
You
like,
laugh.
No, there's a level at which human beings exist where, like, that shit is like, dude, they really just said that? Did they really say Joe Biden fought in the Civil War? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's how you get through it. You get through it with the lulls.
That was the most fake shit ever created. Like, at this point, I mean, I'm almost done. The Robert Spalding book, you're done it. But... Yeah. With the help of Susan Rice, Michelle Obama, whoever was installed on...
that grew up in Iran.
Yeah. Whoever else from the CCP that is on Netflix's board. Good job. I mean, pretty much, that's 2020 in a nutshell right there.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I don't want to name her, but my friend that you were like, that's what she would like. It's like, yeah, I was telling her... She was like, I was like, oh, dude, like, I'm just, like, kind of fucking bummed out. And she's like, just put on Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. That'll make you feel better.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, right. Okay, yeah. Cool. Yeah.
Like, fuck your bells.
Yeah.
Watch Kimmy Schmidt, dude. The second season's even better than the first season.
Yeah, just put on something funny, like, zone out. Like, Kimmy Schmidt.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'm going to do
Instead,
that
I watched
Death to 2020.
Steven Spielberg, Ready Player One.
Really? Is that good?
Nah, it's like a fucking kid's movie because he's a pedophile. But the end of it, there's symbols. There's like pedo symbols.
Did you see de Blasio?
There's like Bahamut face.
Baphomet
face. Yeah. There's a fucking Illuminati eye on a dude's baseball hat. It all happens within like 2 minutes.
They just put up regular. Did you see the thing on Spud Mode with de Blasio's wife?
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
How crazy. That's an egregious face mask.
I don't understand. That was like the Mighty Ducks 2 helmet.
Yeah, it's pretty, you know? Like, that is insane that someone out bought that. But, dude, if you begin, like, a little challenge. You want to start like fucking viral challenge because we do viral stuff. Watch Death of 2020. See if you can finish it.
Oh, like as a challenge?
It is. I fell asleep because I watched Blue Rain last night. Definitely watch that. Sick ass movie. But Blue Rain, very chill. And then I'm going to sleep. I was like, Death of 2020. And then I remember us talking about how like it would be cool to like just go through shit that happened in 2020 yeah. and talk about it. And I was
then like I don't have time.
Yeah, and I was like, I'll just watch this, jog my memory. And I was like, holy fuck. Like what? Like they like it was like almost a PTSD thing watching that because they're like reminding me of all the shit that they and then like laughing about how people believe that this isn't how it went. And like the number one thing was when they started off with the impeachment shit. Like Trump was too worried about impeachment to focus on this, even though we had evidence from the transcripts. It's like Adam Schiff, dude, made up a fucking transcript and use it as evidence.
Where'd you get that though?
They said.
But Bill, where did you get that?
They asked him that and he said, well, that's what I thought.
Bill, where's your source though?
That's what I thought Trump would have said.
Oh my god!
And it's like, yeah, and somehow he got out of the impeachment. Like, I wonder why. Maybe because Adam Schiff has his wire crossed because he's raping black kids at the Chateau Marmont.
They're on a You Are Here map right now because the Washington Post is coming out saying now like the Republicans are denying the election, and it's just craziness. Like it's totally unfounded. There's no evidence. Oh
yeah, you didn't get the election, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm just saying like I woke up today and it was like the Washington Post is like these Republicans are just crazy.
Oh, they're nuts.
Yeah.
They live in they said it in the Death of 2020. The right wingers are living in a clown like
they said clown world?
They didn't say clown world exactly, oh, okay. Like clown party.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, I mean, they went to that, and they were just like, they explained the whole vote by mail and how, like...
I liked how they handled the ability to protest and the coronavirus.
That was ridiculous.
That was a tricky one for them to try to, like... Dude, so much happened during the year that they probably felt like, we have to kind of make this make sense for people.
Yeah.
Let's get some of our favorites, and let's mention Coachella and Beyonce.
Yeah.
And lull everyone into, like, a propaganda...
It's like Davos, Coachella for rich people. Yeah, that's what it is. They just chill and don't make any plans for anything.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's what so they likened Samuel Jackson is just supposed to be some fucking guy. They're all actors. It's none of it's, like, real. Like, all these people are acting as
other
people.
I'm, like, pissed we're talking about it, but just keep
going. So it's, like, comedic set, dark comedy, it said. But he says that his explanation for why the George Floyd riots could happen in the middle of a pandemic is because at least the virus doesn't pretend like it's actually there to help you. Bro, literally 19 black dudes, I think, died this year from cop violence. Keep it in your pants. Obviously, they're helping you. Like, you're out of your... Like, that should not be legal. Like, people are like, you're...
propaganda, you mean?
Yeah, like, you're going... Yeah. You're on 4chan. You're getting, like, propagandized. It's like, dude, that's harmless.
They're probably sitting there going like, we're gonna have to like put a pin on this year,
yeah,
and like make sure we wrap up, we get our side of the story out, like
so bad,
and like they can't come out and just fully say like, this is what happened. They have to mock
the whole time.
They mock the other stuff.
Yes,
you know,
but like, dude, it was like the whole thing was obsessed with race. Like, they were every second
When he equated Trump not wearing a mask, but he would wear it if there was a hood, if it was a KKK hood.
Yeah.
It's like, there you go. You know what I mean?
Samuel L. Jackson. And you know that's fake.
And you know that's fake.
You
dude.
Know how Trump used to roll with all the blacks.
He had a black girlfriend.
Yeah, dude. It is. That might be the worst thing ever.
I don't know. I mean, Netflix has come out with some heavy hitters this year.
That is up there with
Cuties. Did Cuties make the 2020...
No.
Oh, really? Netflix supporting the movie didn't...
He equated...
That didn't make it in the the wrap-up? Maybe it wasn't that big of a deal. I don't know.
You're a schizophrenic psychopath. So you thought the election got stolen, but they counted the mail-in ballots last.
Yeah.
That's why it seemed like
So when the suitcases came in.
It's like if you watch Jaws backwards, it's just a shark spitting a bunch of scared white people back onto a boat.
Oh no, they said that.
Yeah, what's up? That's funny.
Man, they are funny, dude. They are good. Funny. I can kind of see why they didn't pick Shane, because he's not that funny.
Dude.
Like, he's not hitting me like that, dude.
Yeah, I mean, that is, if you watch Shark, Jaws backwards, that's what it is. That's funny. Yeah, then they're just like, yeah, hopefully, like.
Don't you think it's weird that if you could imagine that they're, like, sitting in a room coming up with a script and, like, these, like, zingers.
Yeah.
And they're making fun of white people and then they all start laughing.
Yeah.
And don't you think that's kind of weird?
That's like, what I was doing to you.
Huh? Oh, I know, but I'm just saying, like.
That's what I'm saying, like, a group of people.
In real life, it's totally cool that they're just, like, scared white people. And they're like, oh, man, you got them. That's a good one.
Yeah.
It's like, man, I wonder what that would sound like the other way around.
Dude, that would be the worst. Yeah, I mean, what was ivoryfist.org was their version of 4chan?
I was on a, what was the one that I was on before that was like Stormfront? I was on one of them before.
Oh, yeah,
I was like,
yeah,
this is
yeah,
just
yeah,
sick.
Yeah,
I was sending it. I think I might send it to Matt.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that,
dude, chill with the stormfront.org. I was like, I'm just, dude, it's cool.
Yeah, yeah, that was like extremists from Europe that were all pumped up on each other.
Yeah.
I forgot about that. Yeah, I mean, if they're listening to the Spalding book and then seeing that, it's like, dude.
Yeah, we're at war with China.
That's
China.
That's wild.
Yeah, China. China's trying to take us down, bro.
That's what it seems like.
That combination of the Spalding book and the ladies viral thing that you sent me.
Oh, the chick from Planet Lockdown?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those two videos together, I was like, whoa.
It makes a lot of sense. And it is like, it hurts your brain thinking about like how people let it get to this point with China. But it's like, dude, once you realize that all these fuckers are getting paid off of China, it makes a world of sense.
Yeah, I mean, they banned South Park.
They
canceled Southwire.
Yeah.
I mean, where the fuck is Southwire?
Good point. Yeah, I mean.
They don't have Winnie the Pooh. Like, they got all up in Pompeo's face about how he had his dog playing with a Winnie the Pooh doll. Like, a Winnie the Pooh doll.
Yeah.
His dog was playing with it.
Because or whatever.
He put it on Instagram, and the Chinese freaked out.
That's insanity.
It's, like, legit banned over there. They have no freedom of speech. They have no freedoms.
They're assholes.
And, like, they have that wall around their internet to keep us out.
Yeah, the great
firewall. Showing them like how free you can be.
Yeah.
So they can have their own 5G, and apparently, I don't know if we're getting tricked, but Trump was just like, we could turn that off whenever we want.
That's
why we have Space Force.
Yeah, I really think so. I mean, to think that like they're going to like out of nowhere be more powerful than someone like China was like nothing. How many years ago? Like in the 50s and 40s, they were shit.
Yeah, but dude, they have a 100-year plan. They're carrying out a 100-year plan.
Yeah, I mean.
And they got the EU on their side now.
That was the most insane news I ever read. Like, I can't even argue with people at this point because it's like, dude.
Just give up.
The EU is backing China. China is literally.
They have too much money in the Ponzi scheme.
It's crazy.
They can't get their money out.
It's crazy, dude. China, everyone's sitting there like stroking off G. And it's like, dude. Yeah. He is putting people on trains, the stuff you hate the most, and flying them or
that
bringing,
special stuff that you hate the
bringing
most,
them
and the
to
stars.
Re-education camps, and not a fucking peep from Hollywood.
Well, John Oliver put out a great piece on that. You should check it out.
Yeah. Dude, thanks, John.
How about the phones? Did you get to that part in the book?
What part?
With the phones that they're giving the Africans.
Oh, no, I didn't get to that part yet.
So they developed, China developed a facial recognition. So they gave them all phones with five
SIM slots.
So a family can just share a phone.
Yeah.
So for like whatever they're charging them, they're like giving them for $50, I think.
Yeah.
And then they
get Obama phones on steroids.
Yeah. They just handed them all the phones. But then in the phone is facial recognition technology that's specially designed to tell dark skin.
Holy fuck, that's hilarious.
Yeah, and what they're doing is they needed the AI. China needed their AI to learn black people. So they gave them phones.
Dude.
Isn't that nuts?
It's nuts that, like...
Americans are like, they're watching this. The Pentagon's watching this shit, dude.
Yeah.
And it's just like, they're like, what the fuck is going on? And the whole world's like, they own the... They are, like, running the media. The Chinese are, like, fucking telling all the... NBA stars,
they
how to
own
act,
the NBA.
All this shit, dude.
They own the NBA, they own Hollywood, all that shit. LeBron, like, that one dude was, like, in support of Hong Kong, And like they asked LeBron James about it, and he just goes, I mean, meanwhile, LeBron James, a few months later, will be holding a Malcolm X book and talking about, like, oppression and stuff.
Right.
He's like, I can't speak on that. I don't know what's going on over there. It's like, oh, well, Muslims are getting put on trains to re-education camps and probably killed, and their organs are getting harvested and flown overnight to elites.
Yeah, they take a blood test. Did you get to that part in the book?
No.
They take a blood test. Part of being in the CCP is you have to take a blood test, and if you match, like say it, this would happen here. If we adopted a social credit score,
yeah,
that was attuned to the CCP's values, not the U.S. Constitution.
Yeah.
If we had a social credit score, they would take a look at me and just be like, okay, dude. Like,
you're about 160 grand.
They would just say, what's his blood type? He's a match. And then I get a buzz cut. I get sent to a camp.
Yeah.
And like, they just harvest me.
You disappear.
And they make money off of that. And then one of their big sellers is Israel. I'm not coming at them right now with that, but yeah. I'm just saying.
Yeah. Like, I mean, they do the same thing with hair, too.
Yeah.
They're like big into human hair, and it's all just these Uyghur Muslims that are getting buzz cuts, dude.
Just buzz cuts, dude.
Number one all around to everyone. I mean, it's not even D. Lauser.
That's why I joke about it on the phone with you. It's like, oh, yeah, dude, when we both have buzz cuts on the train, dude, we'll be fucking ripping the bits.
You know what? We really shouldn't pay attention to the fact that there's a bunch of camps with a bunch of people who have buzz cuts, and they're sending them to their death. That really doesn't matter. I don't think that's ever happened before in history. So
yeah,
we'll just see what happens.
Yeah, we're good.
I can't recall a time that's ever happened in history and no one's ever spurged out about it. So we'll just see what China does with this. Maybe
yeah, that book was a great fucking read, dude. Like, it never slowed down. I mean,
yeah.
I shouldn't say read. I know people get triggered. I listen to books because I'm retarded.
He read it to you.
Yeah. I have another grown man reads me books like I'm a child.
In my mind.
Because I'm retarded and I have a child's mind.
Yeah. In my mind, I'm sitting in my trash truck with my legs crossed like a kindergartner, pretzel style.
Yeah, and then I get all excited about parts of it, and then I try to call you, and if you don't pick up the phone, I get really frustrated, and I go back to the book.
It's like, oh,
and then
man.
I text your aunt, and I'm like, oh, dude, did you check out this sick meme?
Oh, man, he said Steve Bannon.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, that was crazy how they were talking about the investment.
I knew he was a white hat.
That was crazy how they were talking about how it's like legit just a pyramid scheme.
It's
like
a Ponzi scheme.
You can invest as much money as you want, and you literally can't take it out.
Maybe these other countries are like, we are fucked if we don't get this Belt and Road thing up and going. They'll never get their investment back. And,
yeah.
But America can save the day with maybe a global economic security plan.
A surge, sir.
Who knows?
I mean, dude, it's wild that, like, that's what I'm saying. So all these companies have all this money invested into China. That's like, the only thing keeping this, like, fucking ball rolling. And they have blackmail on legit everyone.
Oh, he goes into the blackmail, yeah.
If he
goes into Hunter Biden in that book.
Does
that
he?
Dude should be president. Like, that dude is a brigadier general. I think that's the same thing as Stonewall Jackson. Just shout out Stonewall. But, he should just be president eventually. We need this. He was like white pills at the end of that book. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, I'm on like chapter five. I think I have 2 hours left.
The end of the book is like, we have a chance to stop them before they get too out of control.
Yeah.
And we're still like, you know, way ahead of them.
Yes.
They're just the closest thing that we've ever had to a threat. And the media, if you come at them, they're doing a social media strategy of divide and conquer.
Yeah.
He lays it out like how there's an entire plan that they're running.
Yeah.
And they're way like on those like 4chan You Are Here maps.
Yeah.
We're way down.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, they're really winning this.
Yeah. It's crazy that like in that book they were saying that they pay people 50 cents worth of yen a tweet to just tweet out dumb shit.
Yep. And they retweet stuff to create these like fucking weird social things that happen on social media.
Yeah, like trends and
these
shit.
These weird trends that like you'd be like, what are they fucking fighting? What are we fighting about now?
Yeah, that's
like none of it's real if you don't have it.
At this point, dude, if you're on social media, it's like a monsoon of CIA operatives and CCP like mongos with 10 IQs.
It's a cyber war. And like this dude's talking about like setting up what he was talking about, I think, ended up being Space Force. Another wing of the intelligence and military.
Yeah, that they all laughed at.
Everybody laughed at it, but like, we need it. Like, dude, I love how all the late night guys were like, when he brings up Space Force, make jokes about it.
Yeah.
When it is literally like the only thing we need right now is to be able to knock out their satellites and take care of business.
Yes.
And they got Colbert out there. What did you do, Stephen?
Oh, yeah.
I saw you on the fucking Dana Carvey documentary with Louis. You were chilling. You were kind of cool.
Yeah.
You were chilling back in the day with Steve Carell. Like, you guys were boys. Like, this kind of seemed like a cool pack of dudes. And then you got a little bit of that Hollywood success.
Ah, Skippy Podesta saved this kid.
Yeah. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
His kid was sick or his sister was sick or something?
Yeah, kid or one of his family members were sick, and old Skippy came in, probably offered him maybe a nice little Uyghur heart.
Ooh, something like good point, that. Good point, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like the way they're talking about, like, Steve Bannon calling it from fucking, I don't give a fuck if you like him or hate him, dude's been calling this shit, like,
for years now.
They are so fraud, and they're held up by nothing. And that's why we were
call him a racist.
Yeah, I mean, go to the Frankfurt School. Good job on that one. Fucking, you have these people with all these assets that are worth nothing in China. But you come over here and say,
cities.
I have 10 houses, which you don't have to pay for if you can't afford it. The CCP's got you.
Dude, the guy, he talks about the one businessman, the one banker who loses sleep over China. Did you get to that part?
No.
So there's a banker that... These two dudes chill, and they were from around, like, the Philly, New York area. And they, like, they get together, and they're powerful dudes. And they're like, what do you think is going on? And he's like, the only thing I lose sleep over is China. And he's talking about how they built a ghost city that's five times the size of Philadelphia.
Yeah.
No one's in it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's that's got skyscrapers, and it's got five times. Like, dude, in my head, I can't picture that.
Yeah. That's insane. But that's what I'm saying. Like, then you have these fuckers come over here in these Lexuses, and they're like,
30-second review on a 10-year visa.
Oh, yeah, that's insane.
Fuck them.
Yeah, but, dude.
That's why they're on fucking, dude, when I see them.
Yeah, and this is just the CCP agents, our China friends. This is just the CCP agents.
No, even if you're Chinese. Dude.
The cool ones in Hong Kong?
No, I'm talking about the ones here, dude. If they come here, right?
Oh, and you're playing these games? Yeah.
If they come here, they could come here with the best of intentions.
Yeah.
Right? You come here, you're Chinese, you're trying to start your family, maybe you got a fucking sweet deal on a house in Mayfair, Southwest Philly.
Yeah.
And, like, you're chilling. And then one day you get an email from the fucking Chinese government, and they say your cousins and your uncles and your mom, their social credit scores are going to go down to the point where they won't be able to buy anything.
Ugh.
If you don't do this at the company that we got you a job at.
Yeah, dude. Fuck.
And, like, social credit scores, like, once that gets implemented over there, they're fried.
It's over, yeah.
Because if you go against a party, like, you might have your organs harvested.
Yeah. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, remember we were talking a while back, like, how the fuck are these guys, like, just rolling over here and buying these houses cash? It's like, if you're from China, and, like, they were saying, you don't pay property tax.
And you could buy
10 houses and just be like, I don't have the money right now. And they're like, whatever, tack it on the end. But you still have those 10 assets. And you're going over to here.
You can come here and
do whatever you want.
You can go to a bank that fucks with China, like JP Morgan Chase or whatever.
Yeah.
And you can go say, like, can I get a loan against this? And they give you a cash loan, and you come down to Philly and buy it. You basically, like, lowball and wipe out neighborhoods.
Yes.
You know, like, all of a sudden, all the houses are 90 G's, 70 G's, 60 G's. You're like, what the fuck's going on? It's all these cash deals, dude.
It's fucking
people
wild.
That just, there's some fucked up nephew of a house.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That nobody even cares about anymore. Everybody moved to the suburbs.
Yeah.
You got one derelict who's like, I could sell this thing for 60 grand tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
and not to even get started on the shipping lanes, the South China Sea, the fucking fentanyl. I mean, dude, we don't have, like, they have nukes that can take out our aircraft carriers.
Yeah, the shit.
And Obama sold them the fucking tech.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm so fucking pissed. You got me so pissed off today.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy that they just went in the South China Sea and started building, like, air bases and shit. And they just keep on doing this, like, oh, yeah.
And this Spalding dude went to Obama and Hillary and was like, yo, what's going on? And they're like, nothing to see here, man. Keep it moving.
Yeah, you're fucking out of your mind.
It fucking drives me nuts.
To sit there and just be like, oh, yeah, it's not a big deal. They're nothing to worry about. It's nothing to worry about. Like, dude, obviously it is because they got half you motherfuckers on the docket.
And this is why Trump is saying China a million times a day. China virus.
Yeah.
He fucking knows, dude.
Yes. And then that's what I'm saying. Like,
he's getting intelligence briefings.
Definitely.
You know?
Like, you have these, like, dumb cunts like Nancy Pelosi. It's like, all right, bitch, like, what the fuck do you got going on over there? Because, like, this virus fucking hit. You called him a fucking racist. You went down to Chinatown. You danced with all the Chinese people for God knows what reason. And now you're sitting there like, oh, he handled it wrong. Like, you were literally dancing with Chinese people. Just shut up.
Yeah, I'm pissed off, man.
Yeah, it like, that book just goes to show you, like, how far corruption can go.
Yeah.
Like, if people, all these politicians play fucking ball. That's what I was talking to my buddies about the other week. It's like,
oh, your buddies that loves fucking, what's his name?
McConnell. Yeah.
That dude's the biggest, like, they went after Trump and impeached Trump over some emails to the Ukraine.
Yeah.
That motherfucker's married into the CCP.
Yep.
Cocaine, yeah. Mitch.
Yeah, no, the fuck, what's her name? Chow?
Elaine Chow.
Elaine Chow, yeah. And she's, like, head of transportation.
I mean, dude, they're, like, in the seat. They're, like, high ups.
Yeah, her dad's, like, a fucking huge businessman over there. They get tons of money. That's what he's saying in the book.
They fired that dude in the book, too, by the way.
Really?
Yep.
Okay. That's not good.
Yeah. No, he's back now, I think.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
Like, they fired. He talks about it in the book, how, like, you know, do you think it's compromised? Are you compromised?
Yeah. You're married that's into what I was just about to say.
Communist Party or whatever. And then he brings all this shit to them, and then they just kind of go, like, dude, we don't need you anymore. And they get him out.
That was my argument with him. It's like, this guy is married to a woman from the CCP. Now, you can expand this to every single person who probably has their hands in the HSBC banks, whatever the fuck they're called.
This is why when you're starting your shit, I was like, don't do one of them banks, man.
Yeah. So if you have a wife like Mitch McConnell who's tied to the CCP, or you have a business over there or anything like that, like Hunter Biden did, good chance that you're going to do something that's going to go in your favor that might not benefit America but will make you millions upon billions of dollars.
Yeah, they're not patriots at all, dude. They sell out our country in a heartbeat.
Yeah, that like people are like, that's crazy. That in the death to America
dude, they
thing.
They geared up the coronavirus and then they fucking are the main PPP or PPE people.
Yeah.
So it's like that's in the book too.
That's what I'm saying. Like they roll out this huge crazy thing and it's like they control all their media. Anything that comes out of the CCP is controlled by the CCP. So they're going to show you all this stuff, create mass hysteria, and if they have some 100-year plan to fuck up everyone.
Yeah, it's like 2049, I think.
Yeah, you want to fuck up everyone?
Which is weird that they named Blade Runner that.
Yeah, it's weird. Yeah. But you fuck up everyone. You release the test. You release the PPE. If it's real, you contain it. You can make the test say whatever the fuck you want, and you can shut down fucking everyone. And now you see side-by-sides of China with America, New Year's Eve. China's fucking packed. Everyone's partying. America's defeated. All at home. Bunch of cucks.
Yeah.
It's like, what the fuck?
They have us fighting each other.
Yeah.
And they're partying.
Yes. They're all
chilling.
They're
having sick-ass DJs and stuff, but we don't even have.
They're going to water parks.
Yeah.
And then we get to sit home and watch Death to 2020.
Uh-huh.
And
like, they're loving this.
I'm propagandized to oblivion.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm tuning
I'm supposed to just put on Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt.
Chill,
and see
dude.
If I can relax.
Yeah.
Stop trying to find the pedophile signs in all the movies that the known pedophiles make.
Yeah, they taught that like the spread of the fucking virus in Death to 2020 or whatever. It's like, yeah, no one listened. It's like, dude, these people literally lie about everything.
I didn't like in that 2020 thing before you shut it off, and they had the Q mom girl or the Kathy or the Karen or whatever. Yeah. They had her talking about Fauci. And then it was like, but that was before I found out he was an actor or whatever.
Yeah.
It's like, he killed people in the AIDS crisis.
Yes.
Like there's an argument that AIDS isn't that big of a deal, but Tony Fauci's medicine, AZT.
Yes. Fucks you up.
Fucking kills you. And it's what Dallas Buyers Club's about.
Jesus Christ. But
and dude, it's just saying, like, that's how Hollywood was bought out by China.
Yeah.
But not that long ago, they would make a movie. Like,
yes.
Imagine you're Tony Fauci. You know you did this.
You're shitting
and
your pants.
And Matthew McConaughey fucking loses 100 pounds. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Were you the one who was telling me that Anthony Fauci's, it might have been No Agenda, where they were saying it was like Anthony Fauci's sister or something.
Yeah, no, I was telling you that from that lockdown video.
Yeah, like once something's in his head, you're not changing his fucking mind.
I'm just saying, dude. It's
that's
like
abundantly clear right now.
Yeah.
Like
if everybody could just wake up and go, dude, you know what? All of this shit, if you're an American, you're on my team.
Yeah.
I don't even care.
Yeah.
Like, you're fucking love Joe Biden or whatever. Yo, that's brother. Cool. We're at war with China.
Yeah. I mean,
like, the fact that you like him so much is Chinese.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
You're supporting guys putting Uyghurs on plane or on trains, but
it was a $1.8 billion deal or something like that with Hunter.
Oh yeah, Hunter went over there the same week.
On Air Force Two.
Yes. And
I'm fucking gone today, dude.
And there's nothing to see there. That's the same argument with Mitch McConnell. It's like, you can sit there and do the fucking Republican, like, this guy's a good conservative, this guy's
that's
a good Democrat.
That's why I hated that fucking shit with Space Shot.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, I used to have the app for the fucking drops.
Yeah, that's...
And then when the D's and the Dems start, I'm like going, oh, man, maybe they don't know about, like, how they were fucking kids in the White House.
Yeah.
And then I'm like,
George Bush Sr. was fucking
kids. Yeah, they don't
want to
hear about it. It's like, no, dude, the sneaky Dems.
Yeah,
it's like, oh, dude, are you fucking Chinese, bro?
Yeah.
I'm checking everyone's eyes at this point, bro. I need visuals.
Yeah. the way that they, like, they're putting out this cyber war on Twitter, on the news and everything, it's like they're 100%. Eating into your hands. I mean, you segued it last week with trying to explain to me the mass shit, and then you have all these fucking absolute homos, dude. Like,
I thought we were boys.
Yeah, the one guy. Oh, well, obviously, our 3,000 listeners has got to your head, and like, you literally act like you don't know me in public.
Oh, yeah, I know.
But the one guy's like, dude, he's a hypocrite. He said you can't get sucked into it like Q shit. It's like, dude, this is what he's talking about. Like Q shit when they started going Republican and Democrat. The Q stuff was never about that. But yeah, please, dude, write a fucking paragraph because your feelings got hurt, you faggot.
Yeah, and it went so to my head that I definitely wasn't suicidal for 2 days.
Yeah.
And had to have Shane talk me off of a ledge.
Yeah, I mean, dude.
I mean, I'm trying not to cry right now.
Yeah, you fucking, you explain to me how, like, you get bad sides and, like, I'm sitting there.
I'm just saying, like, yesterday, we were at a job. Me and you have no masks on.
Yeah.
I don't ever wear a mask.
Yeah.
But people immediately turn it into black and white.
Oh, yes.
And it's like, me and you were at a job yesterday. Were we fucking heroes? And was Bernadette and the roofer, were they pussies?
Yeah. That's
no.
That's what I'm saying.
We're all, like, just chilling. This just exists right now.
Yeah, that's
what,
like,
this isn't Gold Stars putting Jews on trains.
Yeah.
You're a drama queen. If that was even the analogy, that would be like if you're proud that you don't have a star on. The Nazis are like, hey, congratulations, get on the train.
Yeah.
Every one of us is going on the train.
Yeah, that's what, like, the it's lack of comprehension. Like, them thinking that was some sort of heated argument, I shit you not.
Yeah.
That same exact argument. You could take all the audio from it out and put the other audio of us arguing. If fucking a transsexual who is a man who became a woman is gay. We've had the same exact argument with that. It's like, dude, it's just a conversation.
There's just certain things that they've psyoped people into. Like,
they got me so mad, I would wear a mask.
In the 2020 thing, it's like, you know, the guy sitting there going, if they told him it was a Klan
hood,
he would put it on. That's what I'm talking about. That's all. Just at the extremes.
Yes.
Like, it's on a spectrum. Like, I have to work for a general contractor that we know and love next week and pretty much got you started. And he tells me, yo, the thing is, this lady's kind of nuts. I got to wear a mask all day in her house.
Yeah.
What do you tell me to do?
Wear it.
There you go.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Are you a hero? Am I a pussy?
I'm a retarded trash man.
I'm just saying, like, it's not that deep, dude. We're just talking about this. I don't. Take it easy on my mental state. I'm not strong enough for this, guys. I'm not a comedian. Yeah. I've never bombed. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not trying to be famous. I literally only talk to Bill.
Yeah.
I talk to you all day.
Yes.
I talk to Matt like twice a week.
Yes.
Maybe one of your other brothers will chime in.
Yes.
And then Shane will call me like once a month.
Yeah, dude.
That's my whole world. Like, you make fun of my call list when you see it on my screen. Because I have no, insane. I'm all alone.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, like, if you're going to write a fucking litany of how I'm a fucking, I don't know, dude. Yeah, I can't even do it because it's, you made up a fake me.
Yeah.
And then you attacked it.
Yeah.
And then, but I am crazy.
Yes.
So.
Know that.
I don't know who you are.
Also.
Like, I don't know who you are. So I can't, like, if you say you're calling me faggot.
You faggot.
I can go like this. Bill's calling me a faggot.
Yeah.
Right? But if I read that I'm a faggot,
yeah,
I'm telling myself I'm a faggot.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like, I have voices in my head.
Yeah.
If I read this stuff, it's in my, I'm saying it to myself.
Yeah.
I already say super fucked up shit myself.
Yeah.
That scares me, and I have to have my friends say, relax, Pete. Hey, don't kill yourself today.
Why don't you chill?
Yeah, the whole point of me doing this was to try to get a girl and get more self-confidence.
Yes.
We want this to go to my head.
Yes.
For some reason, it doesn't.
I want you to stop doing this. Yeah, it's insane to watch those people sit there and spurge on the fact that you're trying to say, watch out for going from one extreme to another. Then I got to
I love how you call me the very next day. You're like, oh, I understand what you're saying about the mess. And I'm like, that's cool. I'm like, that's cool, Bill. Thanks, man. Yeah. And then, like, I lay in bed. I don't sleep. The only person that understood what I was talking about was Shane.
Yeah, because he gets the heat.
But, dude, I mean, fucking.
But like, what the
people don't realize how caring he is, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? Me? It's insane.
One of the best guys I know.
He does all this for us.
Yeah.
Whatever, dude.
That's a good. That's
I mean,
a man.
I don't worry about money because he exists.
That's a man.
Because he's got that king energy.
Yes, dude. And we are his noble servants.
I'm just saying, it's like, that's a great.
I will literally
think
kill
about
anyone.
Having that as like a personality or like being that kind of a person.
Yeah.
That you could be like, oh man, I'm going to call him and make him feel better.
They call them kingmakers. Dude, it's crazy to watch. Like, we go off on all this shit and we're always fucking talking. Like, one of the comments was, we come here so we can talk about this stuff, and this is like the last place on the internet. It's like, okay, faggot. What if someone has a different idea than you? Who gives a fuck?
I don't know, man. I had to stay away from him because Shane was like, don't go on. So oh, I yeah. been on it.
It made no sense. You pretty much proved your point the whole time.
It's all like, I was saying was just don't get that deep into it, man. Just worry a little bit. I heard it on No Agenda or something. I heard it on another podcast where they're saying Team Mask and Team No Mask. Yeah. And I was like, that'll be cool to talk about.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't know that was going to like slip into the fact that I'm afraid that I have a shotgun in my house, but I'm glad that I'm short and I can't even pull the trigger. And it really makes you just wonder, like, Kurt Cobain definitely didn't fucking take the roof off his mouth off, dude.
Yeah,
because there's no way he's like small like me.
Mossad agent. Yeah, that was the most infuriating thing. Where like I will legitimately go into Acme and wear a mask. These people piss me off so much.
Well,
that's how much I hate that shit.
I just like the I just don't like
all the Sigmund Freud Juniors, all the tough guys.
These guys also don't understand. Bill doesn't have to ever wear a mask.
Yes.
He can't lose his job.
I could literally.
This is a joke. This is a bit that he does in real life where I am going to go pick up my food and I'm on the phone. I'm on the headset with him and he goes, are you going to put it on? Put on your mask, you little faggot. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. And we have fun with it.
Yes.
And like, all I was saying was, you not wearing a mask to go buy a bottle of water that takes 3 seconds.
Yes.
And then you're like, cancel my order. Like, that's fucking retarded.
Yes.
Because there's people around you that think you're a Klans member.
Yes. That's the other thing. Like, the thinking about how it just completely negates you from fucking even trying to change someone's mind.
Yeah, you're fried. I mean, it's not you're fried. You're right. That's the thing.
Yeah, I know.
Like, you're right. They're trying to put masks on toddlers on planes. I mean, this is crazy town.
Yeah.
But in the day-to-day life.
Yeah.
If you came into that job yesterday and you started spouting off, that would have been awkward.
Oh, yeah.
Because we were walking in a room, and we just walk in with no masks, and then it's a little jarring when you see two other people that have masks on.
Yeah.
And you're like, okay, you know.
Yeah, it pumped me up, though, and she was like, I don't even know why I'm wearing
after this. After the roofer left, she's like, I don't know why I wear this thing on, and that's what everybody's doing.
Yeah.
It's just you can't like ruin everybody's day all day long with this shit.
The weird.
It's not that big of a deal.
I don't know. What would you consider that? Like, would that be making you a straw man once they do some like weird like
I don't know
this
all
is
these...
spade in your head?
I just think that that's a thing that people do. I've done it.
Yeah, I guess so.
I did it to Shane.
Yeah.
Like I knew only had met Shane like for like a minute before.
Yeah.
And then I listened to all these podcasts with Shane with Matt.
Yeah.
And then I meet him in real life, and I'm like, oh, he's not the dude, not in a bad way or anything. I'm just like saying, like, oh, he's not the dude that I had made in my head.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it just happens when you're listening to podcasts. I just, you know, thought maybe I'd have a little bit more time. I mean, that was like hundreds of episodes.
Yeah. That's, yeah. What are we on, like 30-something?
I don't understand people.
We're not necessarily the great orders of the 20s.
Not going to be too many more if they keep this up, dude. I'll tell you that.
What? Yeah. What a fucking faggot response to that shit that was. That was like I was like, yeah, I think I get what Spade's saying. Then on Monday, I start reading the comments like, oh, I get what he's saying. Oh, fuck.
It's cool, man. But imagine like if you were paying someone like $12 a year and calling them a faggot.
Yeah, you're their slave. Like, do you want to Spade to go to your house?
I stepped out of line.
And whip him on a tree?
Yeah.
You big dollar supporter, you?
Oh, it's cool, man. I mean, it's hard for me to, like, I don't want to do this.
Yeah, no normally. Shit. Normally. Hearing that, definitely.
Like, normally, this is kind of like pulling teeth.
Yeah.
So.
Although, our fucking intro game has stepped up now that we're
sponsored by Apple. I moved to a laptop.
Speaking of slaves.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that was like, I think that'll be pretty good. But it's like, yeah, Jesus Christ, fucking blow me, dude.
Make my life very hard.
Yeah, I will literally wear a mask when I go to sleep. If you keep this up, you piss me off so bad.
I mean, it doesn't, you don't have to do that. But
this is like.
I don't know how to explain that I am not, you know. I guess I'm not talking down to you or any of that stuff.
Yeah. I mean, we talk for 8 hours long. A day.
And I'm like the biggest loser. Like, my life is like the biggest loser.
Yeah.
I did that thing with Wes and all them, and it's like they're rattling off like how much money they're going to make and all this stuff. And I'm just sitting there like,
yeah. The fame to your head was one of the nuttiest things I've ever seen in my life. It's like, dude, you are dusted. But fucking, I mean, we got off of that and then just immediately went into hating China. So all of our.
I hate China so much like that, you know.
Dude, that's.
Like, we're legit at war with China, and and the people that are behind China could fit in a room. That's like the Ike shit.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, from what it seems, from listening, that one thing on the Planet Lockdown. The chick, Aust Fitz or whatever her name is.
Yeah.
Shout out Philly, she's from here. And
she killed it.
When
her shit's going viral.
Let us remind you when old Gregory Floyd got a knee on his neck for 8 minutes and 69 seconds.
95% right.
What did we tell you? We told you that they're burning the buildings down so they can get their hands hot, rub them together, and get some nice property because there are opportunity zones. This lady fucking went through, had her autists look at where these riots were. And they happen out of like 33 of 37 places where there's a Federal Reserve, and they all happen right in opportunity zones. Now, opportunity zones are a place where if you make tons of fucking money, you can put your capital gains for the year in a piece of property. But instead of just saving on taxes, get your claws out. Have a fucking riot and light a bunch of shit on fire so then you can buy it for a quarter of the price and build it back up and make tons of tax-free money. That is an absolutely genius fucking plan.
Dude, she was scary, dude. That shit about them having to come up with a
I'm only talking with pen and paper from here on out and drawing circles and lines, dude.
Yeah. Like, when she was talking about how people are going to live to 150 years and they have to kind of, like, brace everybody for this.
Yeah.
That's terrifying. It's so true.
Guys, this is totally normal. Yeah, look at the Rockefellers.
I mean, dude, they're 3D printing organs.
Yeah, that's...
So, I mean, if we are just organs and chemical, if we're just a bag of fucking meat or whatever...
Pretty much.
I don't know if your brain could hold up, though.
Get a new one.
Can you get a new brain?
I mean, I don't fucking
at
know.
At some point, are you anymore? Is what I'm saying.
I wonder what... Yeah. Is there such things as... Yeah,
I believe in God and, like, the soul and, like, the universe. Yeah, no. Astrotheology. Like, this isn't matching up, dude.
There is...
I think they're trying to hack it like Satan would.
Yeah, biohack.
Like, they try to make, like, the machine age, the machine version of what God did. All they can do, all the archons can do is manipulate. They cannot create, dude.
Exactly. That's what you hear talk about, what Jones talks about, what Ike talks about, what every schizophrenic psycho talks about is transhumanism.
Oh, yeah.
It's like that's 100% what it is.
Yeah, she's a pretty level-headed person talking about transhumanism, which is terrifying.
Yes.
You know, like, if that becomes like a normal conversation, people are going to be like, well, I'm definitely not going to be like, I told you so, but I'm going to be like, could you stop making fun of me a little bit?
Yeah. I'm 6'2 now. Shut the fuck up. Yeah, it is crazy. Like, she's sitting there telling you, like, straight up, like, how this looks from a financial point of view. And she's talking to a mongoloid like myself. And I'm like, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, it made a ton of sense.
And they're doing it right in your fucking face. And meanwhile, you're writing hate messages about masks.
They just have to have an entire it's like a five-pronged attack or whatever.
Yeah.
And that same attack is in the there's a new interview that you gotta watch. It came out today with the fucking dude from Overstock.
Oh, Patrick Byrne?
Yep.
He's
doing another interview about the PSYOPs they're running on us.
Oh yeah, I mean, what yeah. didn't I send you and Aunt Patty a tweet about that?
I don't know.
About it was something Patrick Byrne said Seth Rich was proving that he was getting paid by WikiLeaks. Remember that?
Yeah, that's what I've been saying that.
Yeah.
Because of that fucking
95%.
95%. But I remember when I sent that. That's when I sent that Assange thing.
Yeah,
Assange. I just spurred. I saw. I didn't read it.
Yeah.
I saw that spurred, dug into my shit, yeah. and was like, check it out. And Patty, I have clips.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you guys are crazy. Why would they be lying about this?
The
it's like,
whole conspiracy land.
Yes.
Dude, I didn't realize. They're in season two.
What's the second season?
Q.
What?
Q.
Q.
Yeah. It really, but that like gives like
more power,
more credit.
Yes.
To the fucking pedophile ring.
That's, I was watching a,
I'm telling you, if you get a chance, just watch the last 5 minutes of that movie with Steven Spielberg made. It's crazy.
Nah, I'm good. Ever since I watched.
It holds like an egg and it's got like little pedo signs.
You don't need that. I was watching that, Value Entertainment with Robert Spalding. So now I just like, last night I was chilling. Some dude from, one of the dudes in 13 Hours, the real guy, like from Benghazi, he was talking about how it is infuriating how fake the news is. And he said everyone. Like, there's not one news site or any company, any fucking TV show that is telling you the truth. And, like, it's infuriating for those dudes to sit there and watch the news and see what they're saying. Because on all fronts, it's fake.
Yeah.
Like, the whole fucking thing's a smokescreen.
It's fake news.
That's nuts.
The president tried to teach us this.
Yeah, dude, the weird shit about death in 2020 was at the credits.
He'll go down in history as like one of the best presidents of all time.
Yeah, we'll see what happens at six. I mean, that's going to be insane. But at the end of death of 2020, they started like rolling outtakes, but it was just like extra lines that they didn't put in. And they were like, yeah, it was kind of crazy to see a former world leader in like so-and-so, like Brazil or wherever, saying like it was crazy to see Trump shove an egg up, a hard-boiled egg up his ass.
What?
They were saying like 2021, they were like saying, oh, it was crazy to see this happen, like making shit up because they're funny jokes.
Yeah, you're losing me.
Yeah, it was just like they were saying
dark
shit.
Dark comedy, I don't understand.
Yeah, that crazy Netflix dark comedy. They were saying shit like, and then the Trump news channel only lasted for like 1 month and obviously declined.
Okay.
Like they were saying like all this like crazy shit. It's like, dude.
It was hard to watch when they're like, Bolsonaro denies erectile dysfunction rumors. It's like, you just had to throw that in there.
Yeah, they get...
It's like, to think of the great minds, the great comedic minds of our century
yeah.
in that fucking writer room.
You get that fucking Ghostbusters check
they're
in there.
They're big. Like, those actors are taking a hit financially to do that. That's Hugh Grant.
What,
that's
Samuel L. Jackson. Tons of money.
Nah, dude, I'm just saying, like... They're probably doing it
for whatever. They're used to winning white ran Oscars about all white people.
Yeah, they're doing it out of, it's probably like half money, but it's a cause.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's part of like advocacy or whatever the fuck you want to call it.
A virtue signal, whatever. I mean, the Cuban.
Like, I was so confused when the black chick from Saturday Night Live was like, pick a team.
Yeah.
I'm like, was that a joke? Or is she like telling people like, yeah, we should be on teams?
It's a
like,
dark comedy, you bitch.
I'm just saying, if I'm China, I'm definitely going to want to split the population.
Yes. That's what,
you know what I mean? It's like.
They got into the Hunter Biden stuff. And like everyone just like, they're making fun of the Where's Hunter and everything like that. And the lady's like, Hunter Biden, like she does some like wild
tell
spiel.
Tell me they did something about how we're afraid of his dick.
No,
okay,
they didn't.
Cool.
They left that out of there. But they went off some like huge tirade about how it's all fake. CNN faked the election.
No, they didn't.
Oh, no. They're like joking. Like the Q chick's like, all this is fake. The election never happened. CNN made it look like it happened, but it really didn't happen to make them seem fucking crazy. But it's like Hunter Biden, Jim Biden, the Biden family is heavily involved in China. There's paperwork to fucking prove it.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, oh, no, it's all tied in with the crazy conspiracy theorists they're making fun of on the Netflix documentary.
You got to wonder why Gina Haspel and Mitch McConnell actually did meet that one day.
Yeah. Also, I keep on thinking about two things. The fucking dude from Turkey who got assassinated.
Khashoggi.
And the fucking envelopes that got handed out at George Bush Sr.'s fucking funeral.
Oh.
I think about them almost weekly. I don't know what the fuck was sent in, but the looks.
I thought it was going to be Khashoggi.
No, what, Khashoggi and these guys.
Oh, I thought the guy from... I thought Khashoggi was a different guy.
No, Khashoggi's... I thought he's a guy who got killed in the Turkish embassy or some shit.
No, I think Khashoggi's like a reporter.
Yeah, he was a reporter who got killed, right?
Oh, no. In the 2020, they're talking about another dude who's like the head of ISIS.
Oh, no, 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 not the... Yeah, we'll get to that. I'm saying I personally just think about this Khashoggi. Shit all the time.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
The Khashoggi and the envelopes that got handed out.
Yeah.
At seniors fucking... What the fuck was in those envelopes?
I know. They have lip-reading experts that have checked out what they said, what they talked about. Remember when they were talking about how they were handing USBs to each other?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just saying.
The shit they said about that, what, the Soleimani?
Yeah, that's what I was saying. That I thought...
That was insane. Yeah. That was the grossest shit I've
ever
seen.
That's what I thought you were talking about.
No, no, no. Yeah. Yeah, so they brought up how Trump killed him, a guy who's killed countless fucking troops, drilled holes in people's head, the most evil motherfucker on the planet. They called him the Beyonce of the Islamic State. And then they were like, yeah, he had to blow up someone, which it didn't seem like everyone from Iran wanted him blown up. It's like, oh, really? It didn't seem like Iran wanted that? Gee, we shouldn't do it if Iran doesn't want it to happen, right? Right, guys?
I don't know, man. You're getting me down the line of thinking that gets me in trouble. I mean, why are we? Why is Beirut on that fucking video, bro?
Oh, yeah. Multiple times. Over and over and over.
If you're boots on the ground in Lebanon right now, you're probably like, we're about to go to war.
I don't...
You know what I mean? Like it's fucking not... It's not funny. It's not goofy time.
Yeah, so much shit happened in 2020 for you to, like, highlight real quick that Soleimani dude. Like, Washington Post came out when he died. Like, just, he was, like, yeah, some sort of, like,
dude,
intellectual.
In the Hunger Games world, in the Agenda 21 world, man, whatever you want to call it, say you're over living in the, over in the Middle East, and we're just the capital. We're detached.
Yeah.
The fact that that's on fucking TV and Americans are watching it is kind of disgusting.
It's insanity.
You know what I mean? And they're like... They're just getting lulled to sleep. You know, it's like, pick a team.
Yeah.
Like, separate from your family. Don't talk to your family members if they don't believe in what... Don't go to your holidays. Don't go to Christmas.
Yeah.
I mean, if they don't agree with you, they're the opposite of you.
Yeah.
And it's like, watch our videos. Watch Netflix. Watch porn. Watch pedophilia.
Yeah. It was...
It's okay. They have their own sexuality that you don't even know about.
They can consent at 12. It was weird also. Like,
it doesn't fuck with their heads at all.
The absolute like circle jerk about race. And then when you're watching it, you see Samuel Jackson, the fucking human from Saturday Night Live. And excuse me. This is a podcast and we're talking.
Oh,
they're completely reserved. And the black scientist from Africa.
That
was not an absolute caricature.
That was not appropriate.
These guys know what's going on.
That was an inappropriate joke. They don't know how it made it out of the room.
And then you have the fucking crazy chick from North England, who, like you said, are like their rednecks.
Yeah, yeah.
Crazy white Q mom.
That was fucked
And then
up.
The historian who's slightly racist. You see that later
that
on.
That believes in... Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones is real history. That was a very funny joke. Netflix, I might steal that. But yeah, they've been doing it in. I was watching commercials, New Year's Day at my cousin's house, and it's like
the commercials are like white.
These
genocide.
Are egregious, dude.
The commercials is the white genocide video. That remember how crazy that was a couple years ago when
yeah.
I sent you that,
yeah.
And then like now we're just living in it.
Yeah, they were like
we're
all commercials from Sweden, and now we're here. Like, oh, that's wow. Why are you doing that? That's
yeah,
a little weird.
Yeah, it's just weird, man.
Yeah, that it's weird
it's
how
like
they keep
no
on doing
it. It makes no sense. That one Hilton one I always go back to.
Yeah, the Hilton like, one. Wow.
Have you seen it yet?
You showed me
it. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's just like weird how they keep on doing it over and over again. It's like, hey.
That shit's crazy. It's just like everyone's having fun, but when the white people have to have fun, they have to wear their masks.
Yes.
It's like, what the fuck is this?
It's very infuriating because like even if you bitch about it, it's like, oh, well, now you know how black people feel when they were typecast. It was, yeah, okay. So is that wrong or no? Or now we're going to like go tit for tat here.
Yeah, they just want to get power. And I think it's just...
It's a joke.
I think it's a mindset that you could fall into as a person. I don't hold it against those people.
No.
Someone's funding it and it's getting through the writing room and that is China.
Oh, yes.
You know what I mean? And
someone on Netflix is from the CCP. And then the other person, you have Susan Rice and you have Michelle Obama, who, like you said, Robert Spalding's at their fucking desk like, hey, let's go with China. Say, turn around. Let's make cuties.
Turn
let's
around.
Make
and
death
also,
of 2020.
Too, your position's no longer needed.
Yeah.
So he's
we
like,
got it figured out.
So he's writing a book. It's just a call to arms, dude. We need digital warriors.
That's me, dude. Wow, that's awkward for me.
What?
I had my phone on not vibrate. That's kind of a year thing.
Oh, that's definitely a me thing.
Yeah,
stealing my stuff.
I mean, an infuriating view of 2020. They get into George Floyd like, oh.
I don't know how you finished it. I still
one sick, and a half.
I'm still like sick to my stomach from watching half of it.
Yeah, I've talked to people who were like, dude, I remember listening to you guys talking about George Floyd and it was cringeworthy. But now it's like a lot different. It's like, and then I have to revisit it. Double down. Fuck Greg Floyd. The guy was a psycho.
Yeah,
he had a psycho's death.
It's crazy.
That you're on fentanyl. You're getting strangled. That's you're crazy. You're a crazy person.
That they have like the murals and the fucking. And I get it. It's a fucking. It's a symbol. I get it, dude. But when Netflix monetizes it, propagandizes it,
yes,
sends it out to the fucking millennials that are sipping their tea at night and being like,
yes,
oh, I'm getting it. This is the stuff that makes me feel good. I'm a good person.
It's like, yeah, we're going to make like, a mural of him. The guy who had a gun to a pregnant woman's stomach in a home invasion.
Dude, the guy
was
on all the drugs. There's doctors that say he committed suicide.
Yeah.
Because he ate all his drugs when the cops rolled up.
Yeah, that looks like someone, like, if you see his face, like, if someone came in, obviously not if you remember everything we've ever said. I've talked about a man named Marty.
You remember everything, which I'm impressed by.
If someone,
I don't remember anything.
If someone came up to me and go, dude, the fucking cops killed Marty. They had a neck.
If there
were, on his
imagine
neck.
If there was murals of Marty, dude.
If they're like the most humble. And like, I'd like, be like, the cops killed him. Like, fuck. What did he do?
Oh, yeah. Obviously.
Like, what the fuck did Marty get into? It's like.
It would just be like, okay, did Marty. Marty and Dent are smoking PCP again.
Yes, dude. You know? It's just
how
like,
about that cop? How about that dude that was on PCP?
Oh, the guy
video?
Showed you?
The guy, yeah. And yeah. I'm like, when me and Bill were doing my driveway, this dude Dent rolls up and like he's like talking to me. Bill just pieces out. Bill just goes like 10 feet away, lays down, just hides. This guy's got me locked in. He's like, Andrew. And he just starts talking. He literally sits next to me and starts smoking PCP.
Shit, burn my nostrils.
A whole Newport. And I'm like, I started to trip a little from breathing it in. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was like afraid this dude was going to like bug the fuck out.
Do you know what the news
like
said about
Marty
that?
Marty was doing that.
Yeah.
And like, that's, I mean, it's not fentanyl, but
terrorized.
It's that kind of a dude.
He was, dude, he told me one time, he was like, also got me hooked on a song called Hypnotized by Fleetwood Mac.
Oh, great song. Yeah.
And he was like, Billy, I used to smoke PCP, angel dust, and I would just sit back, man. I would love this song.
Oh, yeah.
But then Marty would be underneath the L on a 450 Nighthawk because it was raining on PCP.
Yeah.
And his words, some gorilla looked at me weird. So he beat the fuck out of him. Yeah. This is what happens on
this
PCP.
This is what happens on drugs,
but
guys.
Dude.
We don't paint murals.
Yes. But, like, I'm watching. The video showed you the dude in the Philly subway. Allegedly. Hit a homeless man and then jumped in front of a train.
Oh, his death was so honorable, dude.
He?
Just
but
two hands behind your back. Header.
They said that he was just. He punched a homeless guy and then peaced out in front of a train. I have 7 videos of him doing the people's elbow. For 2 minutes
that's
straight.
Hilarious.
Fucking kicking his face into the subway wall, punching him in the face, and then he jumps in
naked.
Front of the subway. Yes.
Naked.
Hands on his hips.
Yeah, going hands on your hips head first into a train is fucking, that's one way out, bro.
Yeah, the funniest part is everyone I've showed that video, at the end of it, they just go, why the fuck do people always get naked on PCP?
I know. It's
that's the
so
reaction
weird.
To every
it's
single
so
person.
It's so weird, dude.
Like, a dude literally takes
that's
a
like,
header.
That dude was smoking
train.
PCP. Like, we're sitting on the excavator, and I'm just like, this dude might bug the fuck out. Stay cool.
Grab a cobblestone.
In my head, I'm like, don't disrupt his vibe. Like, I'm like, trying to, like, tap into his drug vibe.
You forget when I peaced out.
What do you mean?
You forget why I peaced out.
Why'd you peace out?
Because he said, my name's Dent. D-E-N-T, and you looked at him dead in the eyes and got your knuckle and hit the car and went, Dent.
Oh,
I was
yeah.
like, all right, I'm out. This guy's going to go.
Oh, yeah.
This guy's going to explode.
I thought he was going to go, and we're like, we're like sitting, like, touching arms. Like, he was, like, sitting there, like, leaning into me and shit, and I'm like, this guy's going to fucking bug. This guy's going to bug. I'm just saying, if someone took Dent out with 7 minutes with a knee to a neck, wouldn't it be shocked? Kind of would be pumped.
It's kind of the shit that, like,
just saying if that happened.
Like, the shit.
If something popped off and the cops rolled up and that's how he went down and people videotaped it, I'd kind of be like, yo, That was kind of cool, though.
Yeah. It's like the shit my dad says, like, when I was in school. If I got in trouble for something, you probably did something anyway. Even if you didn't do it that time, you probably did something. It's like, hey, you held a gun to a pregnant woman's stomach.
That was going to come for you.
You deserve to die. That is karma. It came from Derek Chauvin. Not saying I'm pumped on him, but Netflix. Let's not say it was, oh, my God, it was racist that it took the cops or it took them that long to fucking arrest the cops. He died for a $20 bill.
This is like the nicest hoodie I've ever had. Yes. It doesn't look cool, but it's so warm. Yeah. It's so soft, right?
Yes.
The dude that used to rock this was a homeless dude at the park who was just like shitting everywhere, pissing everyone off, got locked up, was trying to get his hoodie. His hoodie was just in the park, chilling. Yeah. Now I have it. Motherfucker.
Yeah, the programming in that is like sickening. Like the amount and like the speed at which it happens and the fucking like.
Amen.
You could set a timer to the jokes. Like the overproduction, everything.
As a video editor now on iMovie.
iMovie on a laptop.
I can tell you that every move there is purposeful.
Yeah.
Like when the fucking music starts, when all that shit. Someone had to sit there and go,
and pick those videos and pick
say
those
Coachella
lines.
And say Beyonce and fucking all this dumb shit.
I mean, that's that video right there is like now what John Oliver is. Like John Oliver.
The Davos is the Coachella for billionaires.
Okay.
Oh, buddy.
It's weird. Like, that's how every show is now, though. Like, if you watch John Oliver now, they'll say so and so. This and they oversimplify someone and make fun of them at the same time. That was everything they did in Death of 2020 was they'll say Boris Johnson, a human scarecrow, and then talk about it. So in your mind, you're like, yeah, fuck this guy. What's he talking about? And it's like George Floyd, an innocent black man who only had $20. It's like, oh, okay.
Needed to fake $20.
Yes, like you absolutely like you steer people in how to feel about everything, and it's like that is program.
Everything is propaganda.
I gave the fuck up, dude. I'm waiting. Hopefully, my boy Pence, and you see him on Memorial Day. That speech he does on Memorial Day.
I don't like how they come at everybody's looks, and you know that.
Yeah.
And it's like the first thing.
Oh, yeah. They
immediately blast people's looks all the time, and it's like that's something that's more dangerous than you would think.
Oh, yeah, dude. Are you kidding me? That's like the dude in the thing, they go like Donald Trump, a 74-year-old obese man. It's like Samuel Jackson. Take your clothes off. The fuck do you look like?
That's kind of gay, man.
what are you making fun of all these people for their looks?
I'm telling you, it's just like their thing.
It's like you're making fun of Donald Trump for his looks.
That's either in our unconscious psyche and it's just coming out, or it's like kind of like, yeah, let's step one. Let's fucking
attack people for how they look.
Attack this dude, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't get sucked into the Boris Johnson thing because they're always showing him coming out of 10 Downing Street.
Yeah.
And the doors, and if you're a painter, man, and you see the doors of 10 Downing Street every fucking time, my whole life, whenever they show British doors like that.
You like that?
So, the dude, take a look.
I'll look at it when I go watching
it's unreal. Again. Yeah. Unfucking real, dude.
Yeah, they went all the way out on that one. That was a very...
I would just say if you get hired to paint 10 Downing Street, you're probably the best painter in the world. Probably.
I mean,
if you do those doors, probably.
It's no St. Dorothy's fucking sign, but yeah, it's probably sweet. Yeah.
If you're ever driving down Township Line, you see the St. Dodge sign. Just saying.
Yeah, real curious to see what happens coming up because the D.C. mayor is trying to put a lockdown until after the 6th.
They're on a You Are Here map, dude.
Yeah.
I'll try to find the Washington Post article. It's wild.
Yeah, people are saying Joe Biden's going to concede before the 6th.
Who's saying this?
Insider intel, brother. I'm a victim of propaganda. Yeah, it seems like it's been all like Biden's been relatively quiet for someone who's like about to take office.
I mean, dude, fucking isn't Bill Clinton dead?
Supposed to be. Where is that motherfucker?
Yeah, like where are all these guys? If someone had was like, yeah,
Haspel's been missing, dude. There's like you told me you had Schiff's tweets, and he isn't arrested. I believe you. Whatever. But where the fuck's Haspel?
I'm trying to find this one thing, man. I'm sorry.
No, it's good. We'll switch over to Patreon. I want to watch that Patrick Byrne thing, and then I'll read that. And then we'll.
Can
just...
you just go on? Hold on.
All can right, I go on never what? Mind,
whatever. You just end it. I'll try to figure this out. Dude, I just want to get back to the